Hey guys, what's up? Brandon here, and today I'm bringing you some more Tribes Ascend gameplay with the Brute class this time around on Bello Mega. And so the response to my video on the Juggernaut class was really good. It sounded like a lot of you guys enjoyed it and found it helpful, and so I thought today I would do a video in that same vein with another class. And as I mentioned, today we're going to be talking about the Brute, which in some ways is actually kind of similar to the Juggernaut in terms of how I typically play the class and the roles that I use it for, kind of that generator offense or generator defense type role. So again, this overview will just kind of go over how I play the Brute class, and you know, hopefully you can take some of what you see in this video and apply it to your own play style. Now, first of all, for those of you who haven't unlocked the Brute class yet, or just haven't played it much, let's do a quick rundown of what the Brute class is and kind of what makes it unique. So first of all, you can see that it is a heavy armor class. You're not going to move very quickly, you don't have a ton of energy, but you do have a lot of health. Now, let's talk weapons. The Brute has, in my hand as you see now, the heavy spin fuser, which is really going to be its bread and butter. It also has an automatic shotgun as its secondary weapon, which honestly I don't find all that useful. I only pull it out in very limited circumstances, and probably the only circumstance that I think it's very useful in is if you're outside and you're facing a light or medium class in a dogfight. Typically the tactic they'll use is trying to jetpack above you, since obviously they can get to a higher elevation than you as a heavy class. And they're going to try to outmaneuver you. So they're going to spend a lot of time in the air, and it's going to be tough to hit them with a midair disc. So if a light or medium class has fairly low health, it can be great to pull out the automatic shotgun and just finish them off that way. That, however, is really the only time that I use the automatic shotgun. I would say 98% of the time that I'm playing this class, I'm holding the heavy spin fuser. So this is a class that really favors someone who's good at disc placement, because the heavy spin fuser does 980 damage upon a direct hit, and that's the most of any spin fuser in the game. By comparison, the soldier spin fuser does 910, and the spin fuser MKD and the light spin fuser do even less than that. So in case I haven't gotten my point across yet, the Heavy Spin Fuser is a really, really good weapon, really one of the best assets that the Brute class has. Now next, let's move on to the special pack. The Brute has a minor energy regen pack, which is a passive effect, not something you have to worry about, and frankly not very useful, because you're not going to spend a ton of time in the air with this class flying around. You're going to spend a lot of it inside, where you're not going to get outmaneuvered by light and medium classes. Now, I've misspoken in my last video about the Juggernaut and said that the Juggernaut had an energy regen pack, but that's not correct. The Brute is the one with the energy regen pack. The Juggernaut actually has a health regen pack, so sorry for the confusion there. Now, last but certainly not least, we have the Brute's grenade, which is called a fractal grenade. And I say that the heavy spin fuser is the class's bread and butter, but it really might be more apt to say that the heavy spin fuser is the bread and the fractal grenade is the butter. Now, you've seen me throw fractal grenades at several points throughout this commentary. They're the grenades that shoot out green sparks in sort of a spherical pattern around where they land. Now, these grenades can be super useful for several different things. The first of which is taking out the enemy generator. Now, I think that fractal grenades are currently the best way for destroying an enemy generator in the game, because you can throw these grenades and they'll do all the work for you as they do their damage over time. You don't have to focus on the generator, you can focus on killing the enemy players that are probably coming after you once they know that you're in their gen room. Next, the fractal can also be really useful for cutting off a choke point. So especially in an area like the corridors around this enemy gen room, if I'm low on health, for instance, I can use a fractal grenade to throw and effectively cut off the enemy's path to me, while I can probably run away and regen health in the meantime. Now, the last tactic I'll mention is not especially skillful or honorable, but it is effective, so I'll talk about it. If you have fractal grenades left and you know you're about to die, let's say if you're surrounded by three or four enemies, and you know you're not going to make it out alive, you can always spam your fractal grenade button and drop them at your feet. And if you're in an enclosed space, your green sparks of fiery death will very likely take out one or two of your opponents. And so you may get some hate if you use fractal grenades like that consistently, but it is really effective for clearing out a room when you're outnumbered. Now let's move on to the perks that I would use with this class. I think there's actually a pretty wide range of viable perks, but the first one that I use is Survivalist. And I think just because of the slaying that you're doing, you always want to be able to get health regenerated from those ammo packs. And so I always run Survivalist on this class. Now for the second perk, I think there's a lot of different ways you could go. Some people may want to go for Hoarder or Explosive Looter in order to get more fractal grenades. Like I said, those are very valuable. Or some people may want to go for Bounty Hunter or Demolitions if you're trying to get your credits up quickly in order to get a tactical strike or orbital strike or maybe get a vehicle, then that may be of more use to you. But the second perk that I typically run with is Egocentric. I think it's a good all-around perk because when you're using the Spin Fuser and Fractal Grenades at close range, you can't help but damage yourself pretty often. So it can be useful to mitigate some of that damage. And I also think Egocentric is helpful for disc jumping, which I think is pretty vital to any class, but especially for heavy classes, you have to disc jump to get across the map because it's very difficult to get going otherwise. So there you have it, a quick overview of the Brute class, and hopefully that helps you kind of understand the role that the Brute is really best suited for. Like I said, I think Generator Offense and Generator Defense are really where the Brute shines, because in close quarters, the Fractal Grenades and Heavy Spin Fuser combination is really hard to beat. Anyway, if you have any Brute tips or tricks to share, feel free to do so in the comments section or send me a tweet. And if you enjoyed the video, if you found it helpful, I'd appreciate it if you'd hit the like button and maybe share it with your friends as well if they play Tribes. As always, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.